You want to grow asparagus at home? You won't believe how easy it is. It's delicious, low maintenance, drought tolerant, and perennial. This is a vegetable that you can grow in your garden for up to 25 years. What's up everyone, it's Scott from New Garden Road. I'm here to inform, inspire, and elevate you. Encouraging biodiversity and restoring habitat is my mission, one garden at a time. Okay, let me share with you some of the basics of growing your own asparagus at home, combined with my insights over the last 10 years. Where do you plant asparagus? You want to choose a full sun location, and keep in mind, this is a vegetable that can get to 6 to 7 feet tall. Besides that, many times of the year, it looks a little bit wild and floppy. So you want to make sure you plant it on the north side of any other crops or vegetables so that it doesn't shade them out. Take the time to really prepare the soil. You could also consider constructing a raised bed. And if you do that, make sure you fill it up with the highest quality soil that you can find. Once you've decided where you're going to plant your asparagus, what are you planting exactly? Are you looking for seeds or crowns? Let's break down the difference. Planted from seed, it can take about 3 years before it becomes productive. And it's recommended that in the first year of production, you harvest conservatively. That's really important. You just want to make sure it gets established. Crowns are bare root stock that are usually at least 1 year old. So that's a worthwhile shortcut in the process. I love how low maintenance asparagus is. Most of the maintenance that I put in on the asparagus happens around New Year's. At that point, the tops have turned yellow and died back most of the way, but I'll go in there and cut them to the soil level. At that point, I'm going to remove my mulch, my drip lines, take away any weeds that might have tried to get hold there, and I'm going to add a nice layer of compost along with an organic fertilizer, and then after it's all said and done, I'm going to add another nice layer of mulch to protect those roots. Although they've proven to be very drought tolerant in my Central Texas garden, I like to give them some consistent moisture throughout the growing period, especially around the harvest time. Other than that, occasional weeding is really the only thing that I have to do, so this is a really low maintenance crop. Let's talk about harvesting asparagus. In my part of the country, it starts about early March and goes through about mid-April. At that point, the top growth on my asparagus is growing so vigorously that I can't really keep up with the harvesting. It's also important to only harvest for a limited period of time. This is important for feeding the roots and ensuring the longevity of the crowns. I like to harvest the asparagus spears when they're in the 12 to 15 inch range and make sure that you cut them at the soil level. You don't want to leave anything else there for some insect or pest to come along and take advantage of. They grow rapidly, and once the head begins to open up and branch out, they become less tender or palatable. Sometimes they're skinny and sometimes they're fat, but once they're about a foot tall, they're ready to eat, and you can expect a harvest several times a week. Fresh asparagus that you grow at home is so juicy. When you pick it right out of the garden, it's one of those things that you gotta savor. You gotta taste it in the garden. That's gonna give you the full experience. That flavor is so tremendous, and the texture is so tender, you're just gonna love it. So you can definitely eat asparagus raw. It's a lot different than your store-bought asparagus. This is gonna be 100% better. I also like to give it a quick saute with some garlic. That's really easy and delicious. I know a lot of people are familiar with and fans of grilled asparagus. I just want to mention that you really don't have to grill it that long. Since it's one of those that you can eat raw, just give it a kiss from the grill. If you're not ready to eat your asparagus, you can put it in the refrigerator. I like to set it in a glass with some water and put a plastic bag on top. That'll really help to keep it fresh and crisp. Otherwise, you could wrap it up in a damp towel and keep it in one of the drawers. Now check out more awesome gardening videos on my channel. Like this one if you like it, and subscribe to New Garden Road for weekly content. You can grow your own food. Keep it organic. I don't know what else you got to say. You know, harvesting, yeah. And once the head begins to branch out and open up, they become